Aloha and welcome to Be Fit for Health. This is Bianca, your host. It's another great Sunday and we have another great show for you. You know, we've been going through a lot of different thoughts and modalities when it comes to our health and well-being. And, you know, it's some things are very medical and some things are maybe a less and more in the terms of holistic alternative treatments. And I like having a combination of both to give us a little bit of a perspective of what else we can do as far as our health is concerned. You know, what can we learn from these different individuals who had these experiences with maybe a machine or a supplement or, you know, procedures that they may have done through their medical doctors. You know, everything is all about information. And the more information you gather, the better well-rounded you'll be health-wise, and you'll take more better care of yourself and your loved ones. And that's the whole point of this show. You know, I started out with my own personal journey with fibromyalgia, and I'm trying to learn, gosh, as much as I can about how the body works. And, you know, being a trainer for almost 30 years and a health coach, I've learned quite a bit, not only through my practices, but also through some of the clients that I've had and their journey. So everything that I have collected, I try to share with everyone that I come across. And, you know, my next guests that I'm going to be bringing on are no different. They are part of a clinic in Kailua. It's they're called VitaFlow, and they're a medical clinic, and they do all different types of treatments, and anywhere from, you know, medical spa like treatments like facials to measurements of your nutrition, so that everything that they suggest is more tailored towards you. And the two individuals that I'm bringing on today are quite extraordinary. They're both a part of the medical community. And the first person I'm bringing on is Dr. Almond Somel. I hope I said her name correctly. And she's a medical director and is a board certified physician in the physical medicine and rehabilitation. She has over 20 years of experience treating injuries and illnesses with products such as Botox, hyaluronic acid. She strives to use the latest medical research and guides her community to leading a healthier and fit lifestyle for many years to come. And she's certified in IV vitamin therapy, which we've talked about in a past show before. And she's also advanced neuromodular and filler injections. So she does a lot of the holistic medical spa type treatments that you would find in a medical spa. And she also is a part of the American Medical Association Academy of Aesthetics and the American Med Spa Association. So she lives in Kailua, and, you know, she's a part of the community there. And so was her a colleague, Lee Loganville, RN. She has got a BSN, and also she's a nurse manager and registered nurse for 24 years. So these guys aren't new to the block. They've been around for a while. She has experience in ICU, emergency room, and a PACU. Well, that was a mouthful. She is excited to bring the medical benefits of a hospital into the community for prevention and optimal health. Lee has a passion for living healthy and has been a yoga instructor for 15 years. She's a certified advanced neuromodular filler injection IV vitamin therapy, and she's a member of the Academy of Aesthetics and American Medical Spa Association. So these ladies are exceptional. I'm really excited to learn from them, and I'm sure you guys will get a lot from it too. You ladies on board?
Yeah, we're here.
Oh, yay. You guys sound wonderful. How is everything?
Good. Thank you.
Thank you so much for taking some time today. I know you guys are busy. You have a clinic to run, and I know that you guys have a lot of different things you need to be doing right now, but I wanted to steal you away for at least, you know, at least 40 minutes of your time to talk a little bit about what you do at your clinic, but also to educate us on some of those modalities that you use there, because I find it very fascinating that you do different types of testing to measure and to also help us not only feel better, but also to look better with some of the other aesthetic products that you guys have there. So I'm going to get started with you, Doctor. Can you explain to me a little bit about what your role is there at the clinic?
The clinic is called VitaFlow Hawaii. It's an IV lounge as well as a medical spa. So the IV component, you mentioned that you guys have had a show on it before. Basically, we're focused on hydration and making sure people get the nutrition that they need to optimize their health and wellness.
Nice.
The aesthetic side is, you know, what most people know, facials. We do medical grade facials and microneedling. We do Botox and filler and that kind of thing. Because if you're feeling good from the inside, people want to look good from the outside. Skin health, you know, skin cancer prevention, because we live in Hawaii and we're all exposed to the sun so much. So we kind of are trying to do a whole body approach to health and wellness.
Well, I think that sounds great, because if you feel good inside, then obviously you're getting a proper nutrition. You're going to look good too within your skin, which is correct. I think you guys have it down pretty good. When it comes to what you do as far as keeping people healthy, what would you suggest as far as people should be doing that's correct in staying healthy?
Well, so right now, you know, health is at the, you know, forefront of everyone's minds with everything that's been going on. So along with proper nutrition, you know, everyone needs to make sure they're getting enough sleep, they're staying hydrated, they're eating well, you know, kind of decreasing the stressors in their lives, which right now are hitting us from all different angles.
Right.
So those are, you know, things that we like to focus on. The, no matter, you know, how much you do, it's still hard for everyone to eat 3 healthy square meals a day, eating
right.
whole foods, you know, making sure you're getting all those vitamins and nutrients that you need. So that's kind of where we step in and give you this little extra boost. We have all different vitamins, minerals, amino acids. So when you come in and kind of, you know, we go through a full health assessment and kind of figure out what you might need. You know, if you're feeling fatigued, if you're, you know, not getting enough sleep, if you're feeling like your diet just hasn't been great because of all the different things going on, we can help supplement with the different antioxidants and vitamins that we have in our IV drips.
Now, you guys are, that's interesting, because I think I was just telling the other clinic that's here in town, but you guys are over in Kailua. It's so great that you guys are popping up in Hawaii. I think IV therapy is, as I discussed before, is so crucial, because as you said, 3 meals a day, we're lucky if we get that. And on top of that, we're lucky if we get nutritious meals on top of that. So if our body isn't absorbing it, like you were talking about the stressors, because your body's in fight or flight, you may not absorb all that nutrients. IV therapy is a really important key to, I think, getting the nutrients into our body instantaneously.
Right. And, you know, as you mentioned, Lee and I have been working in the hospital, you know, for years. And usually what happens, you know, Western medicine is people kind of wait until they get sick. They wait
right.
for some symptoms, and that's when they come and seek that care. And we've been using these same medications, same treatment modalities in the hospital for years. So if we can get out in front of that and make sure that people have optimum nutrition before their body starts to feel those symptoms, before they start to get run down, then you're already one step ahead of the game. So it'll, like you said, help you feel great and also keep you out of the hospital and the doctor's office. So that's kind of what we were aiming for with when we started the clinic.
So
it's to really give people...
I was going to say, so sorry, when you guys give you guys assessment and you're talking about, you know, the difference between Western and holistic, you're obviously taking the more holistic approach to getting information. Now, what does that assessment usually consist of?
Well, so it's a, you know, it's a full questionnaire. You know, we ask about all your health problems, any other medications you might be taking, anything that might, you know, interact, make sure there's no allergies, things like that. But then we also have a whole litany of lifestyle questions. You know, how much sleep are you getting? How much exercise do you do? You know, what's your diet like? Are you taking any other supplements? And we want to get all that information so we can kind of tell you, you know, what's best for you and what your body might need to stay as healthy as you possibly can. Because it is different for everyone. You know, different people have different diets. There's a lot of people who are vegetarian, vegan, you know, what have you. There are people here who have like, you know, Asian influenced diets and that kind of thing. So all of that helps us to know what your body might be lacking and why you might be feeling tired or worn out or can't sleep. Whatever it is, we can kind of help guide you.
So what would you guys suggest for people who are afraid of their immune system? So they want to build their immune system because of the viruses that are out there, and, you know, just making sure that they don't
right.
get sick.
So yeah, right now, vitamin C is a, you know, it's been around for years. There's, you know, over 50 years of research on vitamin C and how, you know, how good it is for your immune system. It also helps with building collagen. It's an antioxidant. Glutathione is another heavy hitter. Your body actually produces glutathione, but as you get older, it produces less and less. So there's oral forms of glutathione, there's pills and stuff, but those, like you mentioned, aren't readily absorbed.
Right.
So the IV glutathione really helps. It's a potent antioxidant. It's an anti-inflammatory. It helps with your immune system. And then zinc is also it's a mineral. Again, a lot of people don't get enough zinc in their diet, partly because, you know, back in the day when people used to farm and they would get all these minerals and stuff from the soil, now there's so much more processed foods and the, you know, mass farming. We're not getting those same minerals and nutrients that we used to. So zinc is another one that's great for your immune system. Mm-hmm. So those are our three heavy hitters right now. We have a thing called the immunity drip that has all of those in there.
Nice.
And then vitamin D, there's a lot of research going on right now with vitamin D and fighting off viruses. So they've done research on the flu virus and how vitamin D acts in your body to fight off that inflammatory response. They're actually doing clinical trials with the new SARS-CoV-2 virus and vitamin D deficiency. And they've noticed that, you know, up to 40% of people are deficient in vitamin D. Even people who live here with all this sunshine, because of the effects of the sun, a lot of people wear sunblock. They're wearing hats and long sleeves to prevent sun damage.
Right.
But their body isn't able to synthesize enough vitamin D.
Isn't that amazing?
So we offer the vitamin D stock.
Yeah. We live in Hawaii, but we're deficient in vitamin D. That's insane. I can't imagine what some other states are like where they're, you know, they don't have as much, like Seattle, they're always, you know, they have rain all the time. So you can imagine how deficient they must be.
Yeah. So those are some of the things that we can offer. Again, these are all, they're all natural, you know, they're vitamins, they're minerals. There's, you know, no one has ever had an allergic reaction to a vitamin, you know, it hasn't been documented. So that's why we feel good about it. This is something that you could go out and possibly get it from your diet if you knew enough about nutrition and were able to spend all that time, you know, figuring out how much vitamin D is in each spinach leaf and things like that. But in this day and age, the research has already been done.
Right.
You can come in and we can help you get your body up to the level that it needs to be for optimal health.
How much are the doses in the IV in itself? How much vitamin C, vitamin or zinc or D you guys are putting in there?
So we can customize it. You know, there's a lot going around about high dose vitamin C.
Right.
So we have, you know, our standard one is, I think it's 2,500 milligrams of vitamin C, the 500 of glutathione, and 2 milligrams of zinc is in our bag. But there are people who come in and say, you know, I want an extra hit of vitamin C because I read this study or what have you.
Right.
And we can always kind of customize that and add in more. And then the vitamin D is 25,000 units per shot. 25,000 IU, sorry, international units.
Mm-hmm.
And that can be given weekly.
Right.
You know, in order to get people's levels up if they need it. So, but again, that can also be customized. You know, sometimes doctors will prescribe up to 50,000 IU a week. And that's something that we could do. If you are vitamin deficient and your doctor has shown you your lab test, then we can always work with you on that as well.
So my question then is, if I was to take 50,000 IUs of vitamin D orally, could there be a factor that my body may not absorb it at the level that it should?
Yeah. And that has to do with your GI system, you know, and right now they're doing a lot of research on the gut microbiome and inflammation. And so most people only absorb about, you know, 20-30% of what they're taking in orally as far as supplements go. And that, you know, people have leaky gut. The interesting thing about the microbiome is it can change, you know, within a day, like from hour to hour, it can be different based on the stressors going on, based on what you ate. You know, if you had a soda at lunchtime or if you had 3 cups of coffee this morning, it's going to change what's going on internally in your gut. So it's really hard to get as much as you need orally. Same with vitamin C. You can take huge doses of vitamin C by mouth, but your body can't absorb that much, and you're going to end up getting stomach cramps and upset stomach and all of that because your gut just can't absorb it. So that's where the IV component comes in. It's going straight into your bloodstream. Your body can absorb all that without having any GI side effects.
Okay. Yeah, that makes a big sense too, because too much magnesium, you can have diarrhea, and that's not going to be fun.
Right.
So through the
right,
IV, then you kind of bypass that, don't you?
Yes, exactly.
Nice.
So like we said, it goes straight into your bloodstream. Your body basically will absorb as much as it needs to get where it's supposed to be. And then, you know, it can work at that level. So the people who are deficient, you know, we do B12 shots. There are people who, you know, they feel amazing afterwards because they've kind of been running at a really low level and didn't realize it. And all of a sudden their body has enough and they're like, oh, my metabolism is better. I'm, you know, sleeping better and I have more energy during the day. And so that's what really helps us is when people come back and say how good they felt. Then, and that's kind of what sells them too, where they realize like, okay, this is actually working because I didn't change anything else in my diet, but I came in for these drips and they can definitely see an uptick in their energy level and their overall, how well they feel.
Nice. So on that note, I'm going to take a really, really quick break. And when we come back, I want to bring in Lee as well. And then both of you guys can start, tag teaming and talking about some of the other components of the IV therapy too. Because I want to talk a little bit about glutathione and a little bit more about the B complex. And I want to kind of dab into niacin too, if you guys have any thoughts on niacin being a part of the IV therapy as well. So hold on, don't go anywhere, you two. And then audience, don't change your channel because we're going to come back into more in-depth talks about a holistic approach to your health.
The Honolulu Club is...
And we're back. Okay, guys, we've been talking with Dr. Allman and Lee regarding VitaFlow Clinic in Kailua. And we're discussing a lot of different topics about right now it's been on vitamins and IV therapy. And the conversation basically is on oral versus, putting the vitamins directly into your blood veins and getting the nutrients quickly. So Dr. Allman and Lee, I know you're on there, so you're welcome to chime in too, please. So when it comes to the potency of the IV, I know we were talking a little bit about the difference between magnesium being oral and then having it IV and bypassing the side effects of diarrhea and not having the cramping feelings. What about the dosing of vitamin C? So if you were to dose the 2,500 that comes in the IV bag, and if you go over that, does that mean that your body's just going to, it's going to be a waste because your body will only simulate what it needs?
It's not a waste in the sense that, like I said, your body will take as much as it needs, but at any given point, your body's need might be greater. So if you're fighting off an infection for cancer, they've noticed in, you know, the research in cancer patients, they're using extremely high doses, like 10,000, 40,000 milligrams, because when the body is fighting off the cancer, it needs that much vitamin C and it will actually absorb those high levels. When people are in sepsis, which is a really bad blood infection, they're in the ICU, same thing. They're giving them huge doses of vitamin C IV and their body is absorbing it because right now it needs it. So our 2,500 dose is kind of just it's a good dose for people who are otherwise healthy and, you know, it kind of boosts your immune system a little. But so like I mentioned, you know, there are people who come in and they ask for an extra little dose. People say, you know, I'm going to be traveling or I'm starting to feel like I'm coming down with something. Can I get an extra hit of vitamin C? Because at that time, their body needs it. It will take as much as it needs and use that up and get them back up to where they need to be.
Wow, that's great. Yeah, I know that also with going into another aspect, you said glutathione is made in the body, so why would we even need to take glutathione then if our bodies make it?
Well, so like I said, as our body ages, you make less and less of it. And also the same, you know, it's an antioxidant. It's helping to fight off the stressors, the oxidative stress. So the more stressors you have, the more you're going to use up that glutathione that you make in your body. So that's kind of where that taking it IV gives your body that extra little bit that it needs to help fight off what's going on.
So how do you guys at the clinic measure someone's, let's say someone doesn't know where they're at with their body's nutrient levels. How do you guys measure their body's ability to, whether it's to absorb certain nutrients or they have enough nutrients? Is there a system or a program or a machine that you guys utilize to do that with your clients?
Yeah, so we have a biophotonic scanner. It's a Nobel Prize-winning patented technology that will non-invasively measure carotenoid levels in living tissue. It uses a resonant Raman spectroscopy.
Okay.
So it provides an immediate indication of a person's overall antioxidant level and oxidative stress. So after we get the score, we can then make recommendations to improve someone's diet and lifestyle. And because they'll have the data in front of them, they can then make an informed decision on what type of supplementation would be good for them. And so it can tell you in a snapshot, really, if the vitamins you're currently taking are working or getting absorbed.
Wow. And how accurate is this machine?
Yeah, so it's a laser, basically. So it measures at the palm of your hand.
Okay.
It's been proven to be more accurate than serum blood levels. So blood is simply transporting the nutrients, so it has a lot of variability. And the laser is measuring in the skin tissue, which is more reflective of true absorption and long-term lifestyle habits. So when the laser kind of hits, like when a photon laser hits a carotenoid, it's going to kind of change the reading. So it goes from 478 nanometers to 518. And then the light changes in the laser from blue to green. So the only molecule in nature that can shift this is a carotenoid, and that's how we're able to get the score.
Okay, so what is a carotenoid?
So a carotenoid is a type of antioxidant, so that's why it gives you a snapshot of your overall antioxidant level. So we're getting, you know, all of our health and our aging processes, we kind of get, are coming at us from free radicals.
Mm-hmm.
So we're exposed to free radicals kind of all of the time. So the antioxidants, you can think of them as like little force fields that surround the cell. So they're helping protect the cell and they're helping keep the free radicals out. So even though we have this protection, studies are showing that kind of what Dr. Samal said earlier is even though people that are really health conscious and eating a good diet, the research is showing that we're still not getting enough antioxidants in our system for that cellular level protection. So that's why we do recommend supplementation.
Nice. And that's why you guys do the IV therapy. So it kind of gives it more of a direct, instant treatment.
Yeah, we have a lot of different, we do have, you know, vitamins that we recommend if someone's needle shy or just wants extra protection or wants to increase their score faster.
Right.
Well, we have a line that we do recommend because of the science and validation behind it. But overall, IVs are going to get directly absorbed into the bloodstream, and so you're going to maximize your benefit.
Yeah, I mean, I totally understand and agree with that. I mean, at first you sound like you're talking about a sci-fi movie when you're talking about carotenoids and laser and all this stuff. But it's funny how we're getting more and more into frequency and energy medicine. And, you know, I do a whole bit on energy medicine with Kelly Nash Montanay over with the electroecuscope, and that basically works with the neurological system on a, you know, very microscopic level. And it's really interesting to me that you guys are doing measurements based on frequency as well, in a energy level way, because we are energy beings and we do work electronically. So it makes sense that we would measure things electronically or frequency based, like ultrasounds, you know, MRIs. These are all sound energy way of measurements. And this does make sense in that realm of family of understanding our health. So when it comes
It's measuring,
go ahead.
it's measuring like the light photons in the skin tissue. So that's how we kind of are able to get the score. But it sounds unbelievable, but it's very validated. You know, it's 2015, it was awarded the top innovation from Business Intelligence Group. It has 50 peer review articles, including a 10-year study from Yale.
Oh.
So, I mean, it's been featured on Discovery Channel and Time Magazine and 60 Minutes, and it's actually backed by NIH and Huntsman Cancer Research, as well as the National Cancer Institute.
Wow.
So the science behind it is really solid. And so it's just a really great diagnostic tool to give everybody the information they need to keep themselves healthy.
So, gosh, I would love to have this machine just personally. It's like I just measure myself and make sure that, especially when you're feeling like run down, you're like, what's going on? What am I deficient in? And then you take that supplement or you eat that food and, you know, you get back online. Wouldn't, I mean, this is like the future. I mean, like, can you imagine if we had that machine in every home? Talk about preventative medicine, and we were able to measure ourselves when we're feeling like run down or feeling sick. And then you're able to go and get the supplements or the supplies that you need to make that person back, you know, put it back to alignment or place of balance. This would be phenomenal.
Yeah, I mean, it's unfortunate that it's kind of taken a pandemic to shift that focus to prevention. But however we needed to get there, like, it's so important, because over time, if you have too many free radicals coming in and not enough antioxidants, right, it puts you at higher risk for cardiovascular disease, right, cancer, diabetes, among tons of other things. So,
well, oxidative stress is like the number one killer for people, and they don't understand this. If you go to PubMed.gov and you type in oxidative stress, you have over 100,000+ reviews that come out. And then you type in your illness, whether it's cancer, or you type in, you know, fibromyalgia, which is what I have. You have, you know, slew of peer reviews talking about the reasons why. And oxidative stress basically tears down your system really quickly.
Yes.
And so you need to know where you're at. And most Western medicine, unfortunately, don't have this way of measurement. They really don't look at oxidative stress as a form of measurement. They look at it more along the lines of, you know, do you have diabetes, or do you have, you know, this, they measure it in different ways. But I think the approach you guys are taking is really great, because now you guys have a measurement. Now you have, you know, a clear understanding of what's going on. It may not be the whole answer, right? And you're not getting the whole picture, but it kind of sets up the client to get on the right path to getting healthier.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we have oral supplements that we recommend too, but we always say that a multi-level approach is good for someone's health, because everybody's a little bit different. So
how else do you guide your clients? I mean, obviously, after this measurement, what's the next step?
So it really depends on their score. So we talk to them a lot about their lifestyle and what stresses they have in their daily life, and what their score actually is. And then we really take it from there to kind of be able to recommend something. The Pharmanex supplements, we do trust just because of the science behind them, like I said. So they're in the physician desk reference. They have 80 peer review studies that are backed by double-blind placebo to guarantee for absorption. And so that's where most vitamin companies kind of fall short, is they're not actually getting absorbed into the system. You know, they're clean. They go through a process to detect one part per billion for 600 different toxins. They're sponsored by the U.S. Olympic team because they've passed the banned substance regulations, and they're endorsed by athletic associations. So because of all the science behind them, that is the one oral supplement that we really feel has done its due diligence and is really effective because of what they've done to chelate them and make that absorption happen if you're not a fan of needles with the IVs. And then it just gives an added layer of protection.
Yeah, you're going to have those people that are not going to want injections. They're going to be phobic about getting that in there. They're like, they may faint or pass out on you. It's just the way it is. But yeah, it's great to have those options, because like you, I've researched a lot too on supplements, and that's my background. I'm an expert in supplements and nutrition. And so my body breaking down as fast as it does with fibromyalgia, you know, I'm in constant deficit. And so the supplements that I need to take, you know, needs to be pure, and it has to be scientifically sound, and it needs to be absorbable. And that kind of stuff is, most people don't know that. You and I know it because we're in the health practice, but, you know, the average person thinks, you know, whatever they get at, you know, one of these stores that we have here in Hawaii is suffice, but their potency may be like 60%. And the rest is fillers, and they don't have the absorbency factor. It doesn't work. You know, there are some supplements that you shouldn't even take at all, because the way that it's manufactured or the way it's the quality is not good. So it does vary. It is very important, that education. So, you know, kudos to you guys on giving good source of supplements to your clients, because I think that from just doing that, it's going to educate them.
Yeah, absolutely.
So as far as the what was the product called? Photonic?
The scanner is called a biophotonic scanner.
Photonic scanner. Yeah. Okay. So now, is this something that is only with you guys? Is it something that people can purchase through you guys or through the manufacturing company? Is this only regulated through medical professionals?
Yeah, so I mean, if a practice is interested in learning about the scanner, they can definitely contact us. Okay. But the supplements have to be recommended by like the clinic.
Got it.
To get a hold of the supplements. They're not over-the-counter supplements.
Got it. So this is great. I mean, the fact that they have access to learning about how they can maybe measure their own, they don't have to have a doctor do this for them. They can do this at their own leisure, right? If they decided to purchase this machine and learn how to use it. Okay, perfect. That's fantastic.
Yeah, it's good to scan about every 2 months because your body's going to change and your stressors are going to change and your oxidative stress. So we recommend like every 2 months to scan just to make sure you're in the same range and doing good. So.
Now, how are you guys receiving clients with this mandates and all the regulations that we have? Are you guys doing in-house or what's happening? How's the scheduling?
Yeah, so we're having our mobile services on hold right now just for the safety of everybody. Mm-hmm. But we are seeing one client at a time and we're taking temperatures and wiping everything down and doing all the recommendations and using all the PPE. And so we're just limiting to one client at a time right now.
Well, that makes sense. I mean, because I haven't been at your facility, so I don't know how big it is. So obviously, it's got to be the social distancing factor, too. You have to keep in regards. So let's talk a little bit about some fun stuff, like our the way we look. So you guys do the medical spa treatment stuff, which comes with the facials and the fillers and things like that. So what exactly do you guys provide?
So we do the hydrofacial,
nice.
Which I mentioned before. Because we are a medical clinic, we can use there are certain serums that are only allowed for physicians' offices. So the hydrofacial is a great, it exfoliates, it extracts, it gets all that gunk out of your pores, and then we can infuse serums right into your skin. After we give it a nice good cleaning, we get that top layer of dead skin cells off, then we put these high potency serums and they really get absorbed right into your skin. So, you know, it's anywhere from half hour to 1 hour treatment, uh-huh. depending on which kind you get. And you walk out of there with just a fresh, glowing, you know, face.
So is it like a microdermabrasion? Is it that form?
It is.
Okay.
Exactly. So it's like microdermabrasion, but it's not as harsh.
Because
I don't know if you've had microdermabrasion,
yes.
but it's almost like sanding off the top layer.
Yes.
So this, and then it dries out your skin. Microdermabrasion, you know, 2 days later, you feel like, you had a sunburn, your skin's really dry. So that's the nice thing about the hydrofacial is after we take off that top layer, it's all done with serum, with exfoliating, you know, alpha and beta hydroxy acids. So we take off that top layer, but then we infuse, you know, moisture and antioxidants and all kinds of great stuff. So your skin looks and feels great for the next week. And then, you know, of course we put sunscreen on and you make all those recommendations. But so the hydrofacial, especially here where it's humid, we're sweating all the time, everyone's got sunscreen on, you know, stuff just your pores get clogged. So this is something once a month we recommend people come in, we get all those top, you know, the dead skin cells off and get all that junk out of your pores. And your skin regenerates every 28 days. So that 1 month mark is great because then you just get this nice, you know, fresh face for the next
skin.
Couple of weeks.
And I would assume this would help with your skin's elasticity and your,
yes.
Yeah.
So the benefit of that, the benefit of kind of, you know, like you said, the serums and exfoliating is there's less fine lines and wrinkles. You don't get that dried out skin look. So you get, you know, a nice fresh looking face. Keeping it exfoliated, there's less chance of skin cancer developing because you are kind of exfoliating those top layers, getting rid of that sun damage. So yeah, there's a lot of benefits to it besides just looking great when you walk out of the clinic.
So that's the difference between a regular facial and a medical grade facial is the fact that you're able to infuse certain types of products that aren't available to regular facialists.
Right. And we can go, you know, if there are people who have, you know, tougher skin or people who have some acne scarring, or even, you know, if they say, you know, there's this mole that my doctor's a little bit worried about, because it's medical grade, we can up the level of our exfoliating acids. Mm. So we can actually go deeper. You can get a much deeper peel. and get rid of the which a regular facial you're not able to do with an esthetician.
Nice.
So that's why we said it's medical grade. We're able to kind of assess what's going on with your skin. If there's any dark spots or something that we think needs to be treated more aggressively, we can do that with this machine.
Well, what's so nice too is that you're also a medical doctor too, and Lee's a nurse. You guys are medical professionals, so you are able to make a more accurate assessment versus going just to a facialist. Not to take anything away from facialists, but you know, you guys do have a medical background. That makes it a bit much more comforting to a patient or a client that comes in that may be concerned, because you are able to look at it more objectively and give them more sound advice.
Right.
Yeah, and it can be customized as well. So there's boosters for wrinkles, there's boosters for brightening. There's a lymphatic drainage component that we can add, and as well as some lip and eye treatments. And so it can really customize the kind of your areas and your concerns as well.
Nice. Well, I didn't know you guys could do that, but that's great. Set me up.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite treatments. I've been getting it for years. So I recommend it to everyone.
Yeah, I've been hearing more and more about the benefits of a hydrofacial. And I know there's like oxygen facials and there's all sorts of stuff. So are there any other type of medical grade face treatments you guys do?
We do microneedling.
Okay.
So as I mentioned, you know, the hydrofacial goes from the top down. You know, it gets rid of that top layer of skin. The microneedling works from inside out. So basically it's a little gun. It has a cartridge with a lot of real fine needles on it. And we numb up your face and we go over your face and we make all these little puncture marks with the needles.
That sounds fun.
It sounds painful and terrible. But what happens is, because of all of these little micro injuries, your body responds by trying to heal all that. So
it
sends all these great healing factors, collagen inducers, all of this stuff,
stem
goes
cells
to those areas.
Yeah.
So from the bottom, you know, out, you're building up more collagen. You can kind of heal some of the scarring, fine lines, dark spots that people get. So it's great because the two different treatments can be used together and you get better results, because not only are you kind of healing the skin from inside out, you're also clearing off that top layer of skin. So you're getting a really good, younger looking face with more elasticity, less wrinkles, less sunspots.
And I'm sure it's going to be a lot cheaper than going and getting plastic surgery. So,
right. Yeah. And that's the thing is, because both of these treatments are recommended, you know, like once every 4 to 6 weeks. So you can kind of alternate them. You know, you come in for microneedling 1 month and hydrofacial the next. So it's real mild. And it's something that if you keep it up regularly, you're not going to need that facelift or that, you know, down the road.
Yeah, it's crazy. And we're in Hawaii, so the sun, you know, does damage your skin and does wrinkle your skin, and it does make your skin, you know, in a sense, saggy. So what are you going to do? I mean, you have to keep up somehow. It's like maintenance, right? Preventative, just like with our bodies.
Right, exactly.
You do vitamins and supplements.
Exactly.
Serums are like the vitamins to your skin, topically at least. I think it's a great idea. I don't know if you guys are doing any of the other, going back to IV therapy. I was talking about this with the other group a while ago regarding niacin. Do you guys do any type of products with niacin, like NAD shots?
Or NAD? We don't do NAD.
Okay.
Yeah, so niacin is a B vitamin, you know, B3,
right.
And that is in our drip. And then, your body takes that and then it turns into nicotinamide in your body, and then NAD and all of that. So because the NAD it's very specific, and a lot of times people can't tolerate it, and it has to be given over several hours.
Right.
It has to be dripped so slowly. And that's why we don't offer it, because it's, you know, it's just not conducive to someone coming in. They don't want to
schedule-wise too,
four hours.
Yeah.
Clinic. So it is something that we, you know, could talk to specifically. If a person was interested in it, we could talk through the, you know, all the benefits of it. And it was something that we could special order.
Right.
But just on our regular menu, people, you know, they want to be in and out within an hour. And so it's just not something that we offer regularly. But there are there's a lot of studies out there, as you mentioned. There's a lot of the naturopaths in town are offering that treatment.
Yeah.
And there is a lot of research on that for anti-aging and longevity.
And the telomeres is supposed to help extend your telomeres,
right,
which is a part of your... You explain what telomeres is, because you're a medical doctor. You probably do it better than I would. What exactly is a telomere, okay, and why is that important for that to be extended?
Yeah. So on your DNA, on your chromosomes, you know, the ends of these strands of chromosomes are called telomeres. And as you age, those shorten. And that's where a lot of the chronic illnesses, you know, the degenerative illnesses like Alzheimer's disease and stuff, have been linked to that. So NAD goes in and it actually helps repair those little telomeres at the end. And that improves longevity. So anti-aging, you know, cognitive health, memory loss, all of those things that are associated with aging are, you know, prolonged that much more. So that's what the research is showing. That's what people are so excited about, is this is something that can help us all live healthier and live longer.
And that's really important, because I know that with NAD, if your Krebs cycle, which is your part of your energy system, and if it doesn't complete itself as we age, because sometimes we get hiccups, then your ATP production, which is your energy product of your cell, doesn't get produced. And that's where we get our energy from. So that's why another reason, right, as a fitness person that I am, I find this to be very interesting, because we're assuming that our Krebs cycle is automatic and that we're going to get abundance of energy from our cells, as long as we eat well and we sleep well and all that good stuff. But sometimes genetically, you might have this disposition where your body doesn't complete the NAD to the NAD plus. Is that what it is? And then you get your ATP. This is really interesting, because most people don't understand that, how important niacin is in our diet and our nutritional factor. We need it. And we need it to support the mitochondria, which is that motor in the cell. So I find this to be an interesting thing. So even if, you know, most places don't do NAD injections, but they do have supplementation. But again, I don't know how much of that your body absorbs.
Right. Yeah. And then that's really hard to measure. Like with vitamin C, you can just draw a blood level and see how much you actually absorbed.
Right.
So there's research behind that. Because NAD, like you said, how it acts and where it acts and it breaks down in your body, it's hard to measure how much is actually absorbed when you take it orally, because it gets broken down.
Yeah.
So that's what, like I said, the research is there and it's, you know, it's backed by it, but it's hard to know if those supplements are really helping in the long run when you take them orally.
Well, I'm looking forward to a day where we are, as a society, have like a hospital that when you go in there and you're feeling off balance, they have gadgets like what you guys have to measure us, and then say, okay, well, you know, you're developing cancerous like cells. Let's put you on these IV drips or these types of things, and let's inject your body in this stuff for a period of a week, and let's see how your body does. Because they're even talking about, you know, there's yeast and there's fungus also that we haven't even discussed. And I know that a lot of clinics like yours don't deal with that, but they're saying chlorophyll helps fight fungus, you know, things like that,
right,
that we could be taking in to help our health. And as a nutrition person, most nutritionists don't know this stuff either. You have to really study the science behind foods to understand how it breaks down into your body and what it does genetically or even structurally to your system.
Right.
It's hard. It's a lot of information. But, you know, people like, I'm so grateful to have clinics like yours, because you guys are starting to build that foundation to a future that might have this.
Yeah, no, and exactly. And, you know, like we said, it's kind of sad that it took a pandemic for us to start looking at, okay, what's going to keep us healthy? What's going to prevent us from getting ill, versus you just wait until you get ill and then you handle it. So I think a lot of people's focus is going to start shifting, and they're going to kind of start looking at the, what do we need to do ahead of getting that chronic illness or that disease. So we're really excited. I mean, we just opened last year.
Oh,
we're,
you guys
really
are new.
Excited that a lot more people are starting to focus on this. They have, like you know, you have like really good questions. You've done your research. You know what you're looking for.
Right.
And those are our best clients, because then we can really take it and run with it. And we're not, you know, we don't have to go back to the basics and explain stuff to them because they're already on board and want to help themselves.
Right. I mean, I guess you could say that you can partner up with maybe medical offices and giving them an option that might allow their clients to come in and get nutritional, you know, IV. I mean, I just feel like we need to educate more doctors or giving these options to these doctors to help their clients. Because at some point, you know, the prescription drugs also take away nutrients from their system, you know, depletes them. And what are you going to do? You need to build back the body in order for them to be able to combat even the prescription drugs. So,
right.
What are you going to do with that?
You know, you give a drug to fix one thing, but it causes another problem. You know, there's that fine line of doing more harm than good with some of the medications out there. So that's where, like we said, you know, everything we offer is all natural. It's, you know, it's stuff that you would get from your diet and your lifestyle if everyone had the time to focus on that and do all the science and know all the research behind it so they can make educated choices.
So, doctor, how can people find you? Can you give us a listing of things so that they can either call you or look you guys up and find a way to reach out to you and get educated from you directly?
Yes, of course. So our website, vitaflowhawaii.com.
Okay.
That has all of our information on there, all the services we offer. You can book online from the website. As Lee mentioned, right now we're kind of doing just appointment only because of the mandate that's out there. So if you can't find an appointment online, you can always call. The phone number is right there on the website. We're on Instagram. We're on Facebook. You can look us up. You can email us directly from the website as well if you have specific questions. We're located in Kailua in the Cinnamon's building. We're on the parking lot side of that building. We're really easy to spot.
Nice.
So, yeah, you can. You can't really pop in anymore because of what's going
Unless
on.
Unless it's me. I'm kidding.
Yeah. But yeah, if you're walking by and you see us and, you know, you can always kind of stick your head in and ask a question.
Sure. Of course.
But yeah, it's nice to be in this community. You know, people are really great in Kailua and they're all very health conscious and yeah, we're really excited to be where we are.
Well, I appreciate you and I appreciate you, Lee, for coming on and educating us. I know we probably went a little over than the time frame that I promised to keep you guys on, but I do appreciate educating all of us. And, you know, your clinic is valuable. Vita Flow Hawaii is, in fact, open by appointment for you guys. Call them. Ask them all the questions you want. Obviously, you two are very smart people, and I'm sure you'll be able to do great things. And I look forward to meeting you one day soon, and being a client and coming in and getting that measurement done for me to see where I'm at. I'm really curious, but definitely take care of you guys selves and stay healthy and keep doing what you're doing. I appreciate the efforts you guys put out there.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, you guys. So listen, we're coming to an end to the show, and I just wanted to do a recap with everybody. And, you know, it's challenging times, and I know that there is a lot of information out there about this and that and the other. And I try to keep it simple, and I try to keep you guys informed about the things that are available. And when you go to clinics like VitaFlow, or, you know, you go to like the other group that we had talked with, Hawaii Natural Medicine, or you go to your alternative medicine doctor, integrative, functional, naturopathic, DOs, all of those guys have a different approach to measuring your blood or your, you know, urine or, you know, like these electrical measurements. These are all just one part of understanding the human body. We're very complex, but yet we're very simple system. And, you know, when you have a good support system out there, you'll get the information much more effectively. And I feel like, you know, with what we have available right now, it's just, you know, there's so much information, especially on the internet. You got to be careful too, though, with the internet, because you need to know where to go and what to look for. So if you go to like PubMed.gov, and like I said before, if you type in something as simple as diabetes and maybe a medication, it might give you a publication or a peer review on some of the things that they've discovered on that. So I want you to start doing your homeworks on some of the questions that you may have, like, for example, your heart, or maybe you have a you know, mom or a dad or a grandmother or grandfather who has dementia or Parkinson's, you know, what type of natural products they can take. I reach out to your clinics, like we just talked with VitaFlow Hawaii. You know, Dr. Allman is very smart. She knows what she's talking about. Lee is really smart. They'd be more than happy to reach out and you know, respond to you, what questions you may have. For me personally, if you need me for anything, guys, I'm here. Go to my website, and I mean this wholeheartedly. There is a contact page there. There is a question page there where if you have any questions on fitness, nutrition, supplementation, if you have a question on where to go for a certain type of a treatment, reach out to me there. I'm more than happy to respond. It's befit4health.com. And if you guys ever want to revisit any of the shows we had in the past, I went ahead and created a YouTube page, which has all the shows. I made them into a video. This is from a you know, podcast MP3 to a MP4, which so that way you have the visual of the guest. You can re-listen to the shows again. That way, if you miss something, you can go back and catch it and take your notes that way too. So that's Be Fit for Health. So other than that, I just want to say thank you so much again for taking the time out on your Sunday. And I know you guys will have a great rest of your day because you have a positive attitude in your life and you know that you've got support here, especially with me and the people that I brought on. And I look forward to my next show with my next incredible guest because I've been lucky so far. I've had incredible guests on the show. And I'm looking forward to educating you guys and being educated myself. So I wish you guys all the best. Stay healthy, stay safe, take care of each other. And I wish you all aloha.